This is the typical CF direct transmission, direct drive transmission for inboard diesel engines. This is
right now, I am going to disassemble this pump. We are going to remove the pump and we are going to analyze internally what happened with this type of straight transmission. Press the ball and enter. And in the opposite direction, if the pressure of the fluid is bigger, compress the spring and the fluid pass over there. This is two check valves in order to allow the flow of the fluid in this direction, entering and returning in this direction. In both. That the servo valve. This is the compartment for the fluid in order to activate the closed pack for forward. This is the compartment to activate the closed pack of reverse, and this is the PTO or hydraulic valve. I am going to explain the forward gear in an inboard transmission for a diesel engine. Danny, this is the crescent, yeah, that produce the pressure, no?
Absolutely.
Increase the pressure. And you have an input port and return.
And a return, correct.
Input over there and return. Ah, of course, the input is in this area and the return in the compressed area.
Correct. Right. So if you look here, you see how this is, I mean, this has been here around the shop. So here, basically, you see that if you put that dry seal on there, it would actually probably damage
grease is
it,
the recommendation.
A little bit of emery cloth just to clean it.
Correct.
And then grease it.
The clutch in a manual transmission, automatic transmission, is composed of three elements. The friction plate is a metallic plate, a steel plate, with a ceramic friction material in both sides. Element is connected always with the input shaft of the transmission. This element is spinning at the same speed that the input shaft of the transmission. With the engine, this element is together. Why? Because this is the other element, the pressure plate. The pressure plate is composed by one disc, metallic disc, with a flat surface that is in contact with the friction plate. The friction plate, at the end of the day, will be in contact between the pressure plate and the flywheel. The clutch plate, this element, that metal pressure and the pressure with the friction material connect with the flywheel. This one connect with this, and this, when you apply, like the video that you have on the screen, when you release the clutch pedal. When you release the clutch pedal, the pressure plate, the friction plate, and the flywheel are connected together. And this element is the torque converter.
Correct.
And the torque converter internally have a similar mechanism that the mechanical clutch. The body, the housing of the torque converter is bolted on the flywheel. For that reason, the first step when you try to remove an automatic transmission is remove the star motor.
Right.
Remove the star motor. And through the hole of the star motor, you have access to those bolts.
To undo.
In order to release
The torque converter. Oh. Yeah. That's the enemy. But the mechanical clutch is considered quiz question. Dry clutch.
Dry clutch.
Dry clutch. And this one, look, this one is considered
wet.
Wet, because it's full of oil internally. It's solid.
It looks like it holds a lot of oil.
Three quarter, four quarter, depending of the torque converter. Wow. For that reason, when the people flush the oil in an automatic transmission, the million-dollar question is, you flush the oil of the converter? No, because it's difficult. Yeah, I know, but you have four quarters.
So okay. How would
I have one fan here in front of this, and only this one is powered. The other one is free.
So that one's the only one that moves all the time?
Correct, this one.
Okay.
And in this one, I can increase or decrease the RPMs.
Right.
With my gas pedal.
With your gas pedal.
Okay, right. I increase or decrease the speed on this. And what happened with the second one? At the beginning, it start to spin.
Right.
And fast, 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 fast. If I increase the speed too much here, the second one move forward.
It's moving forward.
Because it's too much pressure. That's the situation.
So that's what you're just converting that torque. Now that's why they saw a torque
converter. Torque converter.
Right.
This one is this because it's moving at the same speed of the engine.
Right.
At the same RPMs. Okay, look at this. This one is
the other fan
is free
you're talking about.
The oil sample. The ambassador.
Yeah,
of
but
the
that would
oil
be
sample.
The only way to know if that's bad.
Correct.
Because it's not like you can open this up.
Correct.
So the only way to know is to do
it's
the
with
oil,
the oil sample.
Sample.
That's it. This is the oil pump or PTO. The oil enter over there in the neutral position and return and go into the reservoir. This is the neutral position. I don't have solenoids and I have in the other side. In the other side, the neutral safety switch with three positions. The neutral safety switch and the handle, if it's mechanical. If it's electronic, I have two solenoids in both sides. It goes in one direction for the clutch pack of reverse, or goes in the other direction for the clutch pack of forward. This is the function of the servo solenoid. Here.